And the earth was without form, and the darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. And God said,
I can't see a blinking thing.
And God saw the light, and it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness.
So, we'll call this day.
And this will be night.
And that was the first day. God said,
what this place really needs is some firmament.
And God made a firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament.
So, heaven there, heaven, bit of clothing in there, dry land, we'll call it...
And he called it the earth.
Oh, okay. And the waters can be the seas, and we'll have the earth bring forth grass. Lovely. And fruit trees. That bear fruit. That's the point of a fruit tree.
And that was the second and third days. And God made two great lights. The greater which rule the day. And the lesser to rule the night. And he made the stars also. And that was the fourth day. And God created great whales, and every living creature that swimmeth in the sea, and every fowl that flies in the air. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply.
Get in there!
And that was the fifth and sixth days. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day God ended the work which he had done, and he rested.
Upstairs, my God,
yeah.
The Lord of Lords, King of Kings, Light of the Universe, Prince. King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
Between you and me, just Lord will do.
Oh, don't worry about not recognising me. We look different in the light.
What would you say by this side, by the way?
I'll get up.
But Lord, I am not worthy to look upon your countenance.
Yes, I know, but don't worry about that.
What do you think?
You are magnificent, Lord. Your love and your mercy shine.
What about me?
About? The new world!
Its soaring magnificence reflects the fabulous spirit of the glory of the Lord.
Okay. What in particular do you like?
The whole is as magnificent as the majesty of the heavens and the firmament.
How about my deck chair? What do you think of that?
'Tis a glorious golden throne, fit for the Lord of Lords alone.
What do you think of this?
A blessing is upon me, Lord. Your touch is an honour of which I'm unworthy.
Doesn't matter what I ask you, does it? I can tell you to stick your head on my cat's bottom, you tell me how long ago it was.
Look, I just want your opinion, your honest opinion.
I don't understand, Lord.
Of course you don't. You're just an angel.
Why would you understand?
You were made to praise me, not offer opinions.
I just want to know that what I've done here is not a complete pile of rubbish.
It is the most wondrous rubbish.
So, therefore, I'm going to give you the ability to think for yourself.
Oh, don't be worried, it won't hurt.
All right, now, brace yourself and open your mouth and chew. Might swallow as well.
What was that, Lord?
That was a fruit of the tree of eternal thought. A cherry.
I don't feel any different.
Well, you won't, not yet. Not till you start using the mind I've just given you.
I see, Lord.
Yes, now, I know you're not used to this, but I know that deep down, you're really very opinionated. So take your time. Don't be shy. Just say what you think.
Now, about what, Lord?
This, the earth, the beach, the sea, the sky.
I'm getting a pain just about here, Lord.
Don't worry, it's just a headache. I can sort that out.
Take two of these.
Let's look at something in particular then. Might be easy for you. What do you think of the new form?
Well, it's strange. There are all these dangly bits and they all move and some parts a bit are squidgy.
Yeah, some are squidgy than others.
And what are these holes for?
You'll know.
Ah, and there's some more here.
Now, those I'm very proud of. Those are your ears. You hear. You hear through them. They're your ears.
Is that funny?
Take your fingers out of your ears. They're your ears. You hear through them.
Oh, there's another hole here. Do I hear through this as well?
Oh, no. You might talk through it.
Oh, here's another dangly.
You can leave that alone as well.
Now, the great thing about it is it's so flexible. Here, I'll show you what I mean.
Watch this.
Wow!
Look!
I can do it too!
Never mind about that. You just watch this. I can't believe it. Then you get an idea, yeah, just what this baby can do.
You want it? What's it all for, yeah? But what's it all for?
Yeah, this is so that man will be able to enjoy all of this.
Man? What's man?
Oh, are you in for a treat? Oh, you're going to love man. He's just about the best thing I've come up with. I'm proud of orangutans and crotchless panties, but man, oh, it's going to be so good.
Crotchless panties?
Oh, yeah, it's loads of clothing. It doesn't have, it's missing a...
And it's worn by these orangutans.
Interesting image. No, but they're going to be huge. Anyway, where was I? Man, yes, well, this is what it's going to look like. Well, it won't have my... perfect physique for my rugged good looks.
And he's going to live here?
Yeah, well, not Margate, obviously. I've got so much, Lord of the World, to show you. Take my hand.
Well, it was so much simpler before when it was just you and me and an infinite host of angels singing your praises. Well, this was the problem. I sat there listening to you lot praising me and praising me and praising me. Shut up! And I'd start thinking of other things, new ideas. You mean to say, all the time we were telling you how wonderful you were thinking of trees and skies and cow's bottoms and man? Yes. Particularly man, eh? You love him, don't you? Don't you? Oh, Lucy, don't be like that. You know I could never do without you. You couldn't? No. In this new world, there'll be so much more to do. Messages to run. Visions to appear in. Messages to run. Visions to appear in. For man? Well, yes, but oh, that's not all. There's gonna be harps. Harps, yes. Each of you is going to be issued with this marvellous musical instrument called a harp that makes a heavenly sound. Oh, you're going to love it. And you're going to have wings, yes, by the birds, so you can soar around the heavens, looking down on creation, praising me with a harp. All we're going to do is praise you. Right, who is the God around here anyway? That's it. God, they give me 10. Praising, praising, praising. Just because I singled you out does not mean you're special. I could have had any of the other angels. I could have had Gabriel, Steve, Barbara. There isn't a Barbara, Lord. There is, if I say there is. Now come with me. Where are we going? Not sure I should tell you. But I'm taking you to the highest peak of the highest mountain, from where I may be able to see the whole world of the glory of creation. Come on. Here we are. Mind the step. Look. From here we see the whole of the world, the rolling plains and grasslands, yes, the imposing hills and verdant valleys, the lush rainforests and unforgiving deserts. And if you look very carefully, you can just about make out my deck chair. I foresee a time when man will have made a home for himself in all of these places, yes, and spread himself over the entire surface of the world. Like a plague. What? Oh, I see you're choking. You're so funny.
Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
That's from Hare Krishna.
And what's this? Dear Mr. God, you have won a prize in the Reader's Digest Grand Prize. Would you believe it? I've only created the world a week ago, really. I'm getting chucked with it.
Who are all these people, Lord?
All their colleagues, you know, other gods, sort of.
But there is no other god but you, Lord.
Yeah, I did say that, didn't I?
But we worship you as the one true God.
And that's what I am.
Except for all these other gods.
But you still believe in me, don't you?
You wanted to know what I think.
Oh, yes.
About your creation.
Yes.
Well, it's very nice.
Very nice.
But it could be so much better.
How?
Well, it's difficult for me to explain in words.
Oh. Would it help if I gave you the ability to change things? Remake the world as you see it?
That would be perfect.
Oh, okay. Eat this.
So, how's that?
Right, well, this movement of the air,
or the breeze, yes,
it's unpleasant. It should stop. And it's too loud, these birds calling, these waves coming in and out, they should stop. And this light, it's too bright, it makes my head ache.
Oh, it's going to need more than a fig leaf to cover that.
And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden.
Right. Right, Adam, come here. Nice dressing gown. So, oi. Fruit trees, fruit trees. Decking, decking, decking. Small gazebo. Add a bit of class, water feature here. Little cherub peeing into a pot. Fruit trees, fruit trees. Decking, decking, bit more decking, and tree of knowledge of good and evil. Of that tree, leave it, all right? Apart from that, you can eat from any of the other trees. I hope you like fruit. And decking, well, off you go.
And the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every fowl of the air before Adam, so that he could name them.
So, what are you going to call this guy? Frank, Dave, Barbara. Sorry, that's not what I meant. A collective name for all of them. Bungie. Bungie. How about cows? Nah, I like Bungie. Well, they're called cows. What are they called? Cow. Good. Next. Bungie. Try again. Bingle snapper. They're called chickens. Listen and repeat.
Chickens. Chickens.
Bumpy. Next.
What?
Bungy.
And the Lord God brought every creature of the field, every fish from the sea, and every fowl from the air, so that Adam could name them. And it took a long, long time.
Next!
Ma!
Bungy!
And God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam. And as he slept, he took a rib from Adam's side.
He wasn't using it.
And formed from it woman. And Adam said, "This is bone from my bone, and flesh from my flesh, and she shall be called
Bungy." And so you are my wife, and so you can do the gardening. Come on, woman, chop chop. Have a long day. Oh, you missed a bit there. Right, I'm going for my afternoon nap now. And when I get back, I want dinner on the table.
On the table?
The one you're going to build.
And that was the end of the 8th, or is it 9th? I've lost count. Are we still in winter or summertime?
opened, you'll be like gods.
What? If I eat an apple?
Yeah. Go on. Eat the apple.
Oh, you mean
so delicious.
I won't die.
No.
Oh, I suppose one wouldn't hurt me.
And while you're at it, yep. You've had one as well.
Oh, yes. I'll give Adam one. Adam, I've got a surprise for you. And it's not Bungie.
And Eve took the fruit, and she did eat, and she gave one unto her husband Adam, and he did eat also, and their eyes were open.
And we can have apple sauce, and apple pies, and apple fritters, and apples fermented until all these sugar turns to alcohol.
Adam, have you known that lawn? Adam, where is he? Adam.
I'm sorry, Lord. I heard you calling, and I did, because I was naked.
But you're wearing a dressing gown, not naked. Wait a minute. Have you been eating the apples? You have heard.
She made me.
I'm cutting you out. You will lose your deposit as well. Oh, never darken my doors again. I can't believe it. I distinctly told them not to touch the fruit of that tree of knowledge of good and evil. And what did they do? They touched and ate and made things out of and juices and sauces from the stuff of good and evil, tree, fruit, stuff, and pick your own. Oh, and alcoholic drinks. Oh, that makes me angry. Oh, I'm so angry. Oh. Oh, I'm really angry.
Oh dear. It was me all along.
Lucifer the Magnificent, with the help of Sammy the Serpent. Say hello, Sammy.
Hello, Sammy.
We'll forget that ventriloquism, shall we? Sounds a good idea to me. I can't believe they fell for it.
Yeah, talking snake, that's ridiculous.
You are the lowest of the low. For what you have done, I curse you to crawl upon the ground on your belly with your face in the dust.
You see what you've done? Now I'm the lowest of the low. You're a sot with buttons for eyes. I'd say that was fair enough.
I wasn't talking to Sammy. I think you need some re-educating.